Welcome back. Have you seen this week's Newsweek? NASA is looking for aliens, and the British government has released more of their previously confidential UFO files. Are we closer than ever to confirming extraterrestrial life? Joining us with all the latest news about space is Dr. Seth Shostak. He's a skeptic, a senior astronomer for the SETI Institute's Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, and author of Confessions of an Alien Hunter, A Scientist's Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. In San Francisco, James Fox, filmmaker, UFO researcher. Well, as I get through this, we'll be out of program. His new documentary, I Know What I Saw, premieres October 5th on the History Channel. And in London, our man Nick Pope used to run the British government's UFO project at the Ministry of Defense. All our guests are staying put. We have to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
A spaceship load of stories documenting close encounters and mysterious incidents. The UK National Archives has released another batch of the government's X-Files, thousands of pages listing more than eight between 1993 and 1996. The 14 new files debunk some other incidents, but they also show some sightings are just plain strange and unexplained.
Pacific. We'll start with Dr. Shostak, and the organization is SETI, right?
That's correct.
Okay. The new NASA mission, Kepler, is going to apparently maybe find these things. Big story in Newsweek. What do you make of it?
Yeah, well, it's one of the more important things that has happened in astronomy for decades, Larry, because it's going to answer one question: how many cousins of Earths are there out there? How many planets are out there in the universe that are something like the Earth? We don't know the answer to that.
Do you think they might be inhabitable?
Well, you don't know if they're inhabitable. All you know is they're the right size, the right place. They could be inhabitable.
James, do you salute this?
I do. Sometimes when you're looking for something, it could be right under your nose. You know.
Meaning?
I'm not saying that UFOs are of extraterrestrial origin, but they're certainly, through the process of elimination, doesn't appear to be a terrestrial explanation a lot of the times.
Nick Pope, what does the British government say about this? Does it say there are extraterrestrials?
No, the position of the British government is that it remains open-minded about the possibilities. It has looked at the UFO phenomenon for several decades. We've found no absolute proof positive of any extraterrestrial visitation, but we have found consistently over the years some extremely interesting sightings that we couldn't explain in conventional terms. And that's why I support any scientific effort to study this.
Why isn't the United States, Dr. Shostak, more open about this, like Britain is at least saying, hey, it might be there?
Well, a lot of stuff has been released via the Freedom of Information Act. It's also the case that, you have to consider, well, why is it that all the evidence is stacked up by the U.S. government? This is the same government that runs FEMA. They're doing a heck of a job with the UFOs. There have been lying administrations since Roswell. Have they covered it all up? I can hardly believe that the government really has that much to say about it.
James, you did the new documentary, I Know What I Saw. It premieres October 5th. What do you believe, James?
I believe that there are structured craft of unknown origin whizzing around in our airspace whose flight characteristics are so beyond anything we've had. And this is well documented for the last 60 years, and I wanted to say that we managed to obtain an interview that was done in 1979 by Dr. J. Allen Hynek, who investigated UFOs for 22 years for the U.S. Air Force. His job was to give a prosaic explanation when there clearly wasn't sometimes, and he recanted what he'd done for the Air Force and went on the record before he died stating that that we were most likely being visited, and that the flight performances of these things were just so far beyond anything that we have. And I'm not saying that they're ET, but I am saying that we can no longer deny, and I think once this film comes out, people will really see that the debate will shift from do they exist to who's actually piloting these things.
Nick, you were part of the effort to track UFO sightings. All right, let's say they're there. What are they doing there? Why do they keep circling? What are they finding? What is it all about?
Well, I have no idea. And I mean, to a certain extent, I mean, one could speculate endlessly about all this. We looked at it at the Ministry of Defense purely as a defense and national security issue. And to a lesser extent, but we do have cases where these things come dangerously close to aircraft, as a flight safety issue. But I'm not sure we at the Ministry really thought that it was going to be profitable to speculate too much, because our unit was a very small one, and there were a lot of people who said, well, you shouldn't be wasting taxpayers' money on this sort of stuff anyway. So we tended to downplay this subject, even ourselves sometimes. But we said, look, if there's something in our airspace, we need to know what it is, and particularly if its flight characteristics suggest some sort of technology, whether that technology is Soviet or whatever. It, obviously, we're interested in things like aerodynamics and propulsion systems.
James Fox, your new documentary, your new documentary, James, I Know What I Saw, assembles accounts from various UFO witnesses from around the world. Nick Pope is one of them. Let's take a look.
It glided over my house, and there was absolutely no noise.
What I thought to be a kind of a boomerang shape.
4-4, just confirming that all the passengers can see this aircraft.
I'm Fife Symington. In 1997, during my second term as governor of Arizona, I saw something that defied logic and challenged my reality.
I saw one, but I don't know where it just disappeared.
And the saucer flew right over and put down three little gear and landed out on the dry lake bed.
When we come back, I'll ask Dr. Shostak what theories he might support to explain all this. Don't go away. I'm often asked what I think about this. I don't often give my opinions on this program, but I'm certainly open to this. I'm not going to discount it. Anything's possible, and I think the public wants there to be something there. I don't think the government is afraid that we would panic. I don't buy that theory. What theory do you support, Dr. Shostak?
Well, I think that there's plenty of life in space. One of the things we've learned the last dozen years, there are probably a trillion planets just in our galaxy. Not all of them are going to be bad. Some of them are going to be good. So I think there's plenty of life out there. But if you're going to claim there's life here, then where's the evidence we can stack up in the Smithsonian? I don't see it. Where's the evidence that convinces the scientists?
Yeah, why, James? Why would they hide it?
Well, from what I addressed that issue in the film, and I think one of the reasons why is apparently we don't necessarily have control of our airspace, and no governing body wants to admit that. These things apparently fly rings around our fastest jets and have been doing so in the modern UFO period for over six decades. So,
but Nick, what are they? If they're controlling our airspace, to what avail? We seem to fly and land okay.
Well, I certainly wouldn't go so far as to say that they control our airspace. That said, there have been, as James says, plenty of encounters over the years where both commercial airline pilots and indeed military pilots, and I've spoken to many of them, have actually seen these things up close and personal, and where there's corroborating evidence in terms of radar. But I guess what I'd like to see, it always strikes me as somebody with 21 years experience in government, that actually the UFO community and the SETI community are arguably looking for the same thing, but in different places and with different methodologies. I guess I'd like to see them reach out to each other a little bit.
Why not,
Nick, would you do me a favor, please?
Hold on, Jim. Why not?
No problem.
Well, actually, I'm open to that. And in fact, I almost consider myself a part-time UFO investigator because, Larry, every day I get emails, phone calls, telephone calls and emails from people who are having difficulty with aliens in their personal lives, who've seen things. I can't think of a single example where I thought, this is a hoax. They've seen something. It's worth investigating. No. The evidence is just not there to convince
James, me. What were you going to say?
Well, I'd say to Seth, basically, is that the very person whose job it was to debunk UFOs for the U.S. Air Force for 22 years, Dr. Jalen Hynek, did a 180 and basically came out in 1979 and earlier saying that these things did not appear to be of terrestrial origin just because of the nature of their flight characteristics. Excuse me.
But James,
the very
if
person
I did a
180,
would that convince you?
No, Seth, and I hear you, Seth. I'm not saying that I'm a complete believer myself, but there's a physical phenomenon that's taking place here with very unambiguous UFO accounts and radar recordings and photographs and multi-eyewitness accounts, and there's got to be some sort of explanation, and if it's not us, then who is it? It's either someone's been in possession of this technology for over 60 years, and if they have, then they're in possession of revolutionary technology, and if they're not, then we're being visited.
Nick, do you want to believe?
Well, like Seth, I'm convinced that there must be life out there. And I think it would be one of the most stupendous discoveries of all time. So yes, I think it would be a very boring and lonely universe if we were the only life. And after all, it's one of those great fundamental questions, isn't it? Are we alone or not?
So we've been boring in all this time because we don't know, right, Seth? It's a boring world.
It's boring, but it may change within 10 or 20 years.
Do you think we'll ever have an answer?
Well, I think we'll have an answer to the question of...
James, quickly.
Quick question. Seth, I just want you to... How can you explain what people are seeing? Airline pilots, radar operators, military guys. And these are unambiguous cases where, in some of them, they've actually touched these things. What are they, Seth, in your opinion? Have you looked into it?
I don't,
have you talked to witnesses?
No.
I have,
but the fact that they're unexplained doesn't mean that they're alien visitors. They're simply unexplained. There are a lot of unexplained murderers in Los Angeles, but that doesn't mean that these murders were committed by aliens.
Thank you all very much. We hopefully will someday have an answer. As we wrap up,
thanks,
Don
Larry.
Hewitt.